stopped. Okay, so what are we looking at here, Ollie?
This is what I call a clinker.
Why you call this one a clinker?
Because this one has so many things in it.
I can see the lemon or orange eye.
The eyes look like a roller.
Looks like a roller eye, I agree.
Yeah, and he does not roll, he does not do anything. I find him very useful when I use him as a pump. Get him at any random hen, swap the eggs, and
he's a good parent.
He feeds very good. He takes care of the babies. That's what I use him.
Okay. Now, this bird does not perform in the air.
No. I mean, unless it's like, you know, the first few, maybe 30, 40 minutes. But like, you know, I don't fly him.
Okay.
Because he will like, you know, give that negative impact on the group, especially on the young ones.
That's correct.
So on this one.
Flight behavior.
Keep him as a pumper.
Yep.
Swap the eggs, let him take care of the babies, and that's it. That's it.
I agree. That's something to think about when you have extra birds like that. You can use them. They're good for something, you know. I mean, some people get rid of them. They sell them. For those that just want to have pigeons, some people gift them to people that are starting out. This type of bird at a pet shop will probably go for $2 on the run, maybe $3 on the run.
That's a pet shop bloodline.
Yeah, and that's where you got this bird from?
Yeah, pet shop.
Pet shop, you saw it at the pet shop, you figured, let me play with this thing a little bit here and see what it's all about.
That's the pet shop bloodline.
Okay, gotcha. And then, of course, you could always eat them, you know, if you decide to do so. But that's besides the point.
He has a nice color.
I like I do like the color.
He has nice color.
I can see the blue in the red, you know.
You might put him
I like the nice bars.
Hand. You might put him with a nice pen and they will give you something.
Right,
but doesn't change the fact that's a far away breed is going to be what they give you.
Yeah, well, I can tell you that I think for any kid out there starting, if you gifted this bird, he would look at it as a diamond, you know, a diamond just to have the bird, and that's half the battle right there, having the birds. But when you talk about competing and having quality birds and flight quality birds and performance, then you have to move up to this, and that's the Shannon bloodline right here.
I mean, pure Shannon, pure Sheffield, the pure Bowdens. All these are like, you know, proven.
Right.
Now, what if you can get something that can fly, and also has a nice color? Is that a bonus? Sure, it's going to be a bonus.
Well. You are correct. It will be a bonus, and that's what people do. They play around with certain colors, and they attach colors to different type of body styles and performances, flight performance. But again, to each his own, right?
From my experience, I believe this one is going to be the best. This guy, because I have his brother in the flying team right now.
Right.
He flies very good.
Very good.
Same color,
same dun.
Same thing. So this one here is going to be the best among all these babies.
I'm going to go get one of my duns. I'm going to pause this. I'm going to compare my dun to that dun. See if there's any comparison. Stand by. All right, back to the video. As Cross Loft can see here, I bred that this year. I love the body on that. I love the stance. I love the head. I love the way that bird stands and the collar, Dunbar. I decided to keep him in years past. I used to get rid of him, but I like that bird. Same thing, this is a squeaker baby. They have, I don't know, I think that the head's different, maybe?
Flat head.
That one's a little bit more flat, a little smaller. This guy's got a little bit more rounder in the backside. He's flat too in the top. But maybe that'll change with time. I think this one will grow into his face. He's got a long face, but that's just because the feathers, don't let the feathers be deceiving. You know, it'll grow the head into the beak. But yeah, this is a hen right there. That's what I have. Now, this I considered probably a Levette. In my eyes, possibly a Levette background. But I have some that look like your bird right here, your Shannon.
Mm-hmm.
I got them in the loft, but I think this is more like a Levette bloodline.
Good. That's a nice bird.
Thank you. That's 2021. I bred them early in the year. It's old enough to breed. In years past, I've gotten rid of a bunch of those birds.
Mm-hmm.
Now I'm keeping them, and I am going to create more of these colors. Bar, blue bar, Dunbar, Duncheck. Keeping those.
You see, when you come closer,
uh-huh,
not from far away, and you claim something,
uh-huh,
you can show people the proportion of the, like, you know, the physics on the bird, on the body.
Yes.
Like, you know, the wing to the tail to the head, you can recognize which one can fly, which one cannot fly.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Some people don't show their birds that way, so
because there's something, because they have something
they go like this.
Far away.
Look at what I have. No, let's get a little closer. Let's get a bird's eye view. I like to get a little close up closey. This is what you're looking at. Very nice. Is this a hen?
That's a cock.
That's a cock.
Mm-hmm.
Oh yeah, he's a cock. No. I got something that looks just like that guy. Mm-hmm. Feisty hen. See, you can tell the way she's cooing. She's different. The hen. All right. So this video's getting a little longer. I'm gonna stop it right here. But all right, so Ollie, what do you have to say to the viewers out there watching?
Thank you for watching, and thank you for supporting, and be proud of what you have.
That's right.
Do something.
Yeah. Good advice for those that are watching out there. You have a breed of some kind, some type of, and I've always said the tipplers are what? Tipplers are like pit bulls.
They are.
They come in all different shapes and sizes. And now that they've added color into the tipplers, they got a bunch of nice color tipplers coming out there. So you created right here, prime example, Shannon Canadian. Shannon Canadian.
Both of them. Canadians.
Canadians here.
Mother
and of course, you have the Shannon right there, the blue bar with white flight. So it's all what you want in your loft. Mix them, test them, fly them. If they fly well, you score. Right?
Yes, sir.
And you're doing something different.
If it is good, it's for me. If it is bad, it's on me.
All right. Well, thank you for watching my video, folks out there. Ollie, thank you for coming over. And yes, Pigeon Mumbling.
Yes, sir.
I'm off this.